Well, good morning.
Good morning.
And we can say happy birthday to the Lutheran Church because we celebrate Reformation Day, which actually is, of course, but we celebrate it today. And so we're going to do what I've traditionally done on these days is celebrate the fact that we're saved by grace alone, through faith alone, and Christ alone, revealed to us in Scripture alone. And the way we're going to do that is just like God talked to us, so there's no sermon today. Don't cheer too loud. Or as I told somebody, you're not going to get your regular nap. No. We're going to let God speak to us through His Word today. And so there's a section of scripture lessons and then a prayer and then a song tied to each one of those four foundational pillars of the Reformation. And so that's the format of our worship today. So everything's in your bulletin. A warm welcome to you. As we celebrate the Lord's Supper also today, we might fill out one of the shepherding sheets in your bulletin. I think we'll be good to go. We have just a few announcements for our family of faith. This is the last weekend for the collection for the baby layups. It's the last weekend to contribute to the Charter Protect for the school. It is the weekend that we bring food, and thank you. We've got some bags out there across from the office, some food for the food bank. And then this afternoon, if you have that idea, there's going to be a district Reformation service at Beautiful Savior in Milwaukee in 8:30. So all of those things going on today. But today we celebrate the fact that you and I are saved by grace through faith alone and Christ alone. And that means we can rest secure in our salvation. It's really about our security and our identity, that we are God's children, and in that identity we're secure forever as His children. So let's begin our worship with our opening hymn, Mighty Fortress. I invite you to stand as you're able for the first few things.
Thank you.
Spirit.
Amen.
Do you believe that you are a sinner?
Yes, I believe it. I am a sinner.
And how do you know this?
From the Ten Commandments, which I have not kept.
And are you sorry for your sins?
Yes, I am sorry that I have sinned against God and against the sons and daughters of my Lord.
What have you deserved from God because of your sins?
His wrath and displeasure, temporal death, and eternal damnation.
And do you hope to be saved?
Yes, that is my hope.
In whom then do you trust?
In my dear Lord Jesus Christ.
And what has Christ done for you that you trust in him?
He died for me and shed his blood for me on the cross for the forgiveness of sins.
Why should we remember and proclaim his death?
And lead me to be as gracious to others as
I am not ashamed of the gospel.
Because it is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes, first for the Jew, then for the Gentiles.
In the gospel, a righteousness from God is revealed. A righteousness that is by faith, from first to last.
Just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith.
Where then is boasting?
It is excluded.
On what principle? On that of observing the law? No, but on that of faith.
For we maintain that a man is justified by faith apart from observing the law.
Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand.
So you are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus.
For all of you who are baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves with Christ.
There is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female.
For you are all one in Christ Jesus.
Let us pray. Gracious
Father, you have called me to a wholehearted reliance on your grace in Christ Jesus. You rescued me from the foolishness of trusting my own works, trusting you alone for my salvation. Increase my faith, enabling me to grow to rely even more on your love for me. Based not on how good I am, but on how good you are. Lead me to a deeper, generous faith as your trusting child. Amen.
Scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, perfecting and training in righteousness.
So that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work.
Every word of God is flawless. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him.
Do not add to his words, or he will rebuke you and prove you a liar.
Let us pray.
Gracious Father, you didn't leave me to guess what you think and feel about me. You revealed it by speaking through the prophets, the disciples, and gospel writers. You have spoken most directly through your Son, Jesus Christ, my Lord. Help me stand firmly on your word. Let the gift of your Spirit open the eyes of my heart to see, understand, and live. Thank you.
going to use this for our object today. Can you tell me what this is? What is that? It's money. How much is it? Can you tell me? 50. That's a $50 bill. That's right. That's a $50 bill. What could you buy with $50? What could you buy with $50? What do you think? Well, with money. I could buy some food. Does your mom and dad use money to buy food sometimes?
Yeah.
I could buy gas for my car, right? And for most of us, $50 isn't good anymore. I could buy a lot of things. I could buy books, and actually I brought a bunch of books here. Those are all Bibles. They're different kinds of Bibles. And you think about it, why can I buy so much with this money? In fact, one of these books, I could buy six of these books with one of these. Now, does that make sense? I mean, look at all this. This book's got a lot of colored pages in it, just like this has color on its page. And it's got a hard cover that's even harder than this. You'd think this would be worth a lot more than $50 with all the ink on the page and all the pages. And this is just a little piece of paper with some colored ink on it. Why does this $50, why is it able to buy so much? You know why? Because it's just a piece of paper with ink on it. It's because there's a little promise down here. It's almost hard to read, and it says, this note is legal tender for all debts, public and private. Now, that's a promise that's behind this little piece of paper. You know who puts that promise behind this little piece of paper? Well, on the back, there's a picture of, you know what that is? That's the United States Capitol. And it represents the government. And so the government of the United States of America says, I promise that this is worth $50. Now, if I believe the promise, what am I going to do with the $50 bill? I'm going to go buy stuff. If I don't believe it, I might do something like this. Right? Because I don't believe the promise. If I don't believe the promise, I don't get the blessing. I have to trust what the bill says. And the same thing is true when it comes to our faith. Jesus, we say, died for our sins. Well, where do we learn about that? In the church, through the Bible, what the Bible tells us. Who tells us that Jesus died for our sins? God does. In His Word. Now, I can either believe it, and then I get His forgiveness and His peace, and I know His love, and I know that I'm God's child. Or I don't believe it, and then I don't get any blessing. And so God wants us, just like we trust the words on this, to trust the words in here that tell us about His love and His life for us. So let's ask Him to help us do that in our prayer. Would you pray with me? Dear Jesus,
thank you for being
the one who died.
To pay for my sins.
And thank you for giving me
your word to trust.
Help me to believe. And trust in you.
By your Spirit, to share in as the way, the truth, and the life.
faith in our triune God. In the words of the Nicene Creed,
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God's word for stewards this day. From Romans chapter 12. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, for this is your true and proper worship.
Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and prove what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will.
I invite you to be seated as we dedicate our offerings to the last two verses of Christ the
gospel and lead us deeper into your truth.
confession of the Christian faith in our day, especially for our missionaries as they confirm the faith of their hearts with the confession of their mouths. Give courage to your church that our witness may be bold and convincing.
That the gospel may continue to be preached and taught with purity and power, and that the name of Jesus Christ may draw people to you.
Protect all who serve in your name. Be with our servicemen and women, especially those far away from home. Bless all who serve us close to home, our government officials, those committed to serve in our police and fire departments, and all others in their daily vocations.
Keep them safe as you serve, and grant that we may live together in peace and in harmony, that the gospel may be proclaimed without hindrance.
Supply the needs of those living in poverty. Move your people to share the resources you've given to ease the suffering of the hungry and homeless. Strengthen and heal those who are ill, especially Dick and Rick, Karen and Charlene, Genevieve and Joanne, along with those we name before you in our hearts. Grant special care to Betty Loki as she's hospitalized, and grant to her medical team success as they treat her needs. Grant peace to all who are troubled in mind or spirit, and comfort to all who mourn. We rejoice with Dick and Marcy Schmidt as they celebrate 67 years of marriage together. Continue to attend their way, giving grace and strength to them and to all married couples. Attend to each of us according to our needs and your gracious will. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after the supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God,
keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give to each of you his peace.